Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. This is our 27th episode for Paper 1 MCQ series of SET and UGC NEET examination. You can watch our earlier 26 episode, link for them is given in the description. And please don't forget to write your score in the comment section. Moving on to the first question. Question is, the content of communication is called. So friends, the content of communication is called message. And the message passes from channel to the receiver, and the sender is the one who sends message. So the correct answer is content of communication is called message. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, who is better teacher? Options are, the one who strictly follows the disciplinary guidelines, the one who devotes full time to school, and the one who is interested in overall development of his students. And option D is one who develops quality leadership in students. So friends, the correct answer for this question is the one who is interested in overall development of the students. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The next question is, students who keeps on asking questions in the class, he should be advised to meet teachers personally. Option B, should be encouraged to participate in classroom discussion. Option C, should be encouraged for self-learning. Option D, should be encouraged for continue questioning. So friends, here correct answer is should be encouraged for continue questioning, because questioning while learning is a good habit, and it will like if you stop that habit, then it will be like killing the curiosity of the student. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, identify the unethical practice of the researchers from the following. So these questions are from research aptitude. So the unethical practice is, see, options are avoiding plagiarism. So you should avoid plagiarism. This is ethical practice. B, avoiding duplication. This is also a ethical practice. You should avoid duplication. And avoiding manipulation, option D is also an ethical practice. You should avoid manipulation. So the unethical practice here is avoiding the reliable data, avoiding the reliable information is an unethical practice. So friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. The answer is C, avoiding reliable information is an unethical practice. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, effective learning means. So options are modification in behaviors of learner, B, consistency in behavior of learner, C, to recall information by the learner, and C, D is good performance of the learner in the examination. So friends, the correct answer for this question is modification in the behavior of the learner. So the effective learning means modification in the behavior of the learner. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, basic purpose of the communication is. So friends, if you have studied, is the basic purpose, there are five purposes of the basic purposes of the communication, and the main purpose of the communication is to inform, to pass the message. So the correct answer is option A, to inform. The basic purpose of the communication is to inform. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, person who transmits a message is called. So friends, this question is from the communication section. So so the options are A, receiver, B, sender, C, decoder, D, barrier. So the correct answer, the person who transmit a message is called sender. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is required while reading? The options are A, ability to comprehend, B, reasons for reading, C, help in reading, and D, time for reading. So friends, these all the options looks correct, but the correct and the most probable answer for this question is ability to comprehend. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, one number in the following number series is wrong. Find out that number. So friends, if you, this is a question from the number series, and if you look at these numbers, like if you try to subtract, or if you try to add, or if you try to do multiplication, you will not be able to
get the correct answer. If you if you know the squares of the numbers, then you will understand that the 196 is the square of 14 and 169 is of 13, 144 is of 12 and 121 is of 11. But 101 is not a square of 10. So it should have been 100 in this series. So the correct answer here is 101. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the
last question for today is 1 terabyte is equal to. So friends, this is about memory conversion. Options are A, 8 GB, B, 18 GB, C, 10 24 GB, D, 30 GB. So you have to answer this question. I will leave it up to you to answer this question. If you like this episode, please subscribe to Global Online University. Thank you for watching.